الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وإن أفضل الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. أيها المؤمنون عباد الله، we would like in this khutbah to take a hadith from the hadith of our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. This hadith was reported by Ibn Hibban and others, and was authenticated by Al-Imam Al-Wadi'i as well as Al-Albani. Ja'a Ubayd bin Umayr wa Ata bin Sulayman ila ummina Aisha radiyallahu anha. These two of the tabi'een, they came to our mother Aisha radiyallahu anha. So Ubayd bin Umayr, he said, ya ummah, akhbirina bi'ajabi shay'in ra'aytihi min rasulillah. Oh, our mother, tell us of the most amazing thing that you have seen from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَسَكَتَتْ. She paused to think. What would she say about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Would she tell them about how diligent he was with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? كَيْفَ كَانَ يُوَاصِلِ السَّوْمِ. How he used to fast continuous days on end. Would she tell them of how he used to stand in the night prayer حَتَّى تَتَفَطَّرْ قَدَمَاهُ, until his heels would split from the standing? Would she tell him of his jood, his kindness and his generosity, and how he used to give? كَانَ يُعْطِي عَطَى مَنْ لَا يَخْشَى الْفَقْرِ. He used to give a giving of the one who does not fear poverty. What would she tell them about the most amazing thing which she has seen from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? After thinking, she said, لَمَّا كَانَ لَيْلَ مِنَ اللَّيَالِي قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يَا عَيْشَةَ ذَرِينِي أَتَعَبَّدْ لِرَبِّي. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, oh Aisha, one night, leave me to worship my Lord. And he was beside her. So she said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنِّي أُحِبُّ قُرْبَكْ وَأُحِبُّ مَا يَسُرُّكْ. Oh Messenger of Allah, I love for you to be close to me, but I love also what is pleasing to you. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got up, fatatahhar. He woke up and then he purified himself with the ablution. Then she said, fasalla, he began to pray. Fabaka hatta balla hijra, he began to cry in the prayer until he wet his lap. وَكَانَ جَالِسًا, and he was sitting down. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, while he was praying, he began to cry until he wet his lap. Then she says, فَبَكَى حَتَّى بَلَّ لِحْيَتَهُ. He continued to cry until he wet his lihya, his beard. And we know the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was كثيف اللحية, as it comes in Muslim, from the hadith of Jabir bin Samurah. He had a thick beard which was big. And from the hadith of Ka'b bin Arat in Bukhari, that his beard was so big that when he was praying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the silent prayers such as Dhuhr and Asr, they would see the movement of his beard and they would know he's reciting the Quran. So this beard, which was large in size, became wet. And his lap was wet. Then she says, فَبَكَى حَتَّى بَلَّ الْأَرْضِ. He continued to cry until he wet the floor. This is our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who we know his sins were forgiven. The one who we know that he was sent to mankind as a rahmah, as a mercy to all of the creation. And he is crying, this crying. The believer should ask himself why. Why is it that he is crying, the likes of this crying? And when the Fajr prayer entered, Bilal radiallahu anhu came to him. And he was asked, O Messenger of Allah, why are you doing this? And Allah Azza wa Jalla has forgiven of your sins. He said, أَفَلَا أَكُنْ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should I not be a slave who is thankful? So this is from thankfulness to Allah Jalla wa Ala. This type of crying in which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing. And then he also said, لَقَدْ أُنزِلَتْ عَلَيَّ اللَّيْلَةِ آيَاتٌ وَيْلٌ لِمَنْ قَرَأَهَا فَلَمْ يَتَدَبَّرْهَا. وَيْلٌ لِمَنْ قَرَأَهَا فَلَمْ يَتَدَبَّرُهَا. Woe upon the one who reads these ayat which have been revealed to me tonight, وَلَمْ يَتَدَبَّرْهَا, and he does not ponder and reflect over them. And then he recited the ayat from Surah Al-Imran, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. In the creation of the heavens and the earth and the changing of the night and the day, there are signs for those who have been given correct intellects and sound minds. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in this hadith, we see the type of person he was. One who was thankful to his creator. One who was fearful of what Allah Azza wa Jalla has prepared of punishment. This led him to cry, this led him to weep from his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sadly, some of us, we live in this world years upon end, and we do not shed a single tear from the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or from thankfulness to what He has given us. My brothers in Islam, the ulama, the likes of Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullahi alayhi, mentions that the heart and the eyes, they have a connection. So if the heart hardens, then the eyes, they become dry. This is sadly the state of many of us. Our hearts have hardened, and we know not. The fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla has been removed from our hearts, and we are living in a state of heedlessness, unaware of what awaits us with Allah Jalla wa Ala. And this is of great sorrow. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was one who cried, not every single day maybe, but in times, and he gave hath and showed virtue towards the ibadah of crying. Abdullah bin Shakhir radiallahu anhu, he tells us, Ataytu an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa huwa yusalli. I came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was praying. Walahu azizun ka aziz al-mirjal. And he was humming and crying and moaning like the sound which is made by a pot placed upon the fire when it's boiling. So this was the sound which was coming from his chest. He is humming and moaning from crying. And this hadith was reported by Ahmed in his Musnad, and it is authentic. Likewise, the Salihun, from the likes of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, there were those when they were reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were reminded of the Akhirah, they would cry from the fear of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Anas radiallahu anhu bin Malik, he tells us, وَعَذَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَوْعِظَةً لَمْ أَسْمَعْ مِثْلَهَا قَطْ. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us a reminder and an admonishment, لَمْ أَسْمَعْ مِثْلَهَا قَطْ. I did not hear the likes of it ever. Then he said to the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا عَلِمْتْ لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. If you knew what I knew, you would laugh little and you would cry much. If you knew what I knew, you would laugh little and you cry much. Why is this? He is one who has been shown the Jannah and the Nar. In the hadith which is in the Sahihain, when he was praying the Kusuf, Salatul Kusuf, and he was praying, and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam went forward, and he went to grab as if he was grabbing something. And when he was in the prayer, he moved back in the salah. He began to take steps back. And after this, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said, "O Messenger of Allah, we seen you try to grab and we seen you go back. Why?" And he said, "I was shown the Jannah and I tried to take from some of the fruits. And if I would have brought them, the people would have continued to eat from them. Ma baqiyat ad-dunya, as long as the dunya remained. And I was shown the hellfire in front of my eyes. So I began to step back. Lo ta'lamuna ma alimt, la dhahiktum qalilan wa la bakaytum kathira." If you knew what I knew, he is telling them, you would laugh little and you would cry much. These are the realities which are awaiting us. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, being people whose hearts were pure and fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us, Anas radiallahu anhu, about them, فَغَطَّ أَصْحَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وُجُوهَهُمْ لَهُمْ خَلِيلٌ. The companions of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, they covered their faces. They began to moan. They began to moan and cry. Sadly, we are laughing, my brothers in Islam, much and we are crying little. We are laughing much and we are crying little. It has become fun and enjoyment, this worldly life that we are in. We are not preparing as we should for the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what has caused our hearts to become hardened and we know not. And the hardness of the heart is from the things that Allah Azza wa Jal disparaged the people who came before us from the Yahud and the Nasara. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً. Then their hearts became hard after this, and they were like stones. Rather, they were harder than stones. Their hearts became harder than stones. How can a piece of flesh become harder than stone? This is from the alam al-ghaybi. This is from the world which is unseen to us. But we believe in it, that the person when he distances himself from Allah and he is cheating with his regard to his relation with his creator, that he is distancing himself from Allah and his heart is hardening. And Allah tells us about them that their hearts were harder than stones. فَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارُ. For indeed, from the stones are those that split and the water passes through them. وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِتُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. And from the stones are those that fall down because of the fear that they have from Allah Jalla wa Ala. A stone falling from the fear of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And we are continuing upon sin. We are doing haram and we know we are doing wrong. My brothers in Islam, it is upon us to take advantage of the likes of the opportunity which has passed us in Ramadan, to rectify our hal. Do not put your conscience away. Do not silence your conscience. When your conscience is telling you, "Akhi, what you're doing is wrong," repent to Allah. Become a better Muslim. Strive in worshipping your Creator. We all have this. This is wa'id Allah fi qalbi kulli mu'min. There is a wa'id, a reminder of Allah in the heart of every believer. As it comes in the hadith of Nu'man bin Bashir, which is in the Sahih al-Musnad of Al-Alamat al-Wadi'i. There is a wa'id in our hearts of every believer, telling him about the good and reminding him. Do not silence that wa'id. If you continue to silence this wa'id, this reminder from Allah Azza wa Jalla in your heart, then you're only endangering yourself with regard to the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ibadah of crying and weeping, this has virtues in it, my brother in Islam, which are found for those who are righteous, found for those who are preparing to meet their Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this was from the ibadat done not only by the people of this ummah, but even those who came before us. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ إِذَا يُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ يَخِرُّونَ لِلْأَذْقَانِ سُجَّدًا. Those who came before, when the ayat of Allah are recited upon them, يَخِرُّونَ لِلْأَذْقَانِ سُجَّدًا. They go and prostrate upon their faces. يَخِرُّونَ لِلْأَذْقَانِ سُجَّدًا وَيَقُولُونَ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّنَا إِنْ كَانَ وَعْدُ رَبِّنَا لَمَفْعُولًا. Glory be to Allah. Glory be to Allah. Certainly the promise of Allah is something which will happen. وَيَخِرُّونَ لِلْأَذْقَانِ يَكُونَ وَيَزِيدُهُمْ خُشُوعًا. And they fall upon their faces and cry. وَيَزِيدُهُمْ خُشُوعًا. And this increases them in khushu'. This increases them in khushu'. When the ayat of Allah are recited upon them, they fall upon their faces and they cry, and this increases them in khushu'. The ayat are being recited upon us, maybe the whole Quran, and there is no effect. And some of us, the Ramadan enters and the Ramadan exits. وَهُوَ هُوَ. And he is the same person as he was. Why is this, my brothers in Islam, that it is happening? Allah Azza wa Jalla is merciful to us. He is giving and He is forgiving. What has happened to mankind? And what has happened to our hearts? Ya ayyuha al-insan, ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. O man, what has deluded you from your Lord who is kareem, who is merciful? Allah, He is asking us in the Quran, Ya ayyuha al-insan, ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. O man, what has deluded you from your Lord who is kareem, who is kind and giving? Alhamdulillah Rabbi. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، إخواني في الله، this action of ibadah which the righteous slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave them tawfiq in implementing. This has virtues and merits which we should be striving to obtain. It has virtues and merits that we should be giving effort in obtaining. From these virtues and these merits is a hadith of Abi Huraira, which is in Bukhari and Muslim, authentic hadith. In this authentic hadith, our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions to us 7 categories of people who will be under the throne of Allah Jalla wa Ala on that day, when the people will be sweating and drowning in their sweat. He reminds us of 7 categories of people who will be saved on that day from the heat, and they will be placed underneath the throne of Allah Jalla wa Ala, in the shade where they will be seeking safety, where they will be rejoicing in pleasure. Who are these people? From them he mentioned sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَرَجُلًا ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ. And a man who remembered Allah while he was alone, فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ, and his eyes became teary and he cried. This is a great virtue, a merit for the believer seeking safety on that day when the heat is overcoming the people, when the people are drowning in sweat from their ankles, to their knees, to their thighs, and some of them, they will be drowning in their own sweat. How can a person drown in his sweat? This is again from the things which are from the alam of the ghaib, from the world of the unseen, which we believe in. The people, they will be drowning in their sweat on that day. And from the people who are saved is one who remembered Allah while he was alone, and he cried from the fear of his creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a virtue that we should be striving and obtaining, my brothers in Islam. This is a virtue we are in need of. Also from the virtues of crying from the fear of Allah Jalla wa Ala is what is found in the Sunan from the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, where he tells us in this hadith, Aynan la tamassuhum an-nar. There are two types of eyes or categories of eyes that the fire will not touch them. Aynun bakat min khashyatillah wa ayn batat tahrus fi sabilillah. An eye which cried from the mercy, from the fear of Allah, and an eye which remained awake the whole night, keeping the Muslims secure and protecting the Muslims. These are two categories of eyes that we should be striving and being from. My brothers in Islam, this is a reminder for us all, including myself, that we should be striving more and dedicating ourselves more to our Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are days in this dunya, these days for us, they are numbered. Every single one of us, his days are numbered. And every day you wake up is an opportunity to be doing better, as it is an opportunity for you to destroy yourself, as our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us. كل الناس يغدو فبايع النفس فمعتقها أو مبقها. Everyone wakes up and he's either saving his soul or he's destroying it. فبايع النفس فمعتقها أو مبقها. Either he's saving his soul or he's destroying it. So let us not be from the category of people who are destroying their souls, who are doing sin, who are doing haram, who are being disobedient to Allah, who are leaving off the salawat, who are lying, who are cheating, who are being dishonest, who are harming the people. Let us strive in being from those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin. Allah, He loves those who repent to Him as He loves those who return, who purify themselves. نسأل الله عز وجل بمنه وكرمه وفضله أن يوفقنا إلى الأعمال الصالحة وأن يتوب علينا وأن يغفرنا ذنوبنا ولوالدينا ولسائر المسلمين وأن يعين إخواننا المسلمين حيثما حلوا وكانوا وأن يفرج همهم وكربهم والحمد لله رب العالمين.